I would like to thank Horticultura and Professor Natasha Urosevich from the University of Pula for the invitation to participate in this conference. The report will be divided in two parts. The first part, Catalogue of Austro-Hungarian Fortification and the Forte Cadines Candidacy for the European Heritage Label, which I will introduce. Second part, for Cadine in the Europa Heritage Label and Valorization of Trentino Fort Network. It will be presented by Trentino Historical Museum Foundation. With an assignment of the province of Trento, I have done the catalog of fortification of the Austro-Hungarian Empire. To study the existing fortified heritage in the countries that historically were part of the empire. The aim was to promote initiative of valorization of this important European cultural heritage. Description of different steps of the work. Book 1, History and the Proposal, Development and Fortification. School of Fortification from the French to Prussian, finally the Habsburg. Main defensive system, polygonal system, intrenched field, fortified region. Tape of the fort, the tower of artillery, the polygonal fort, the armored fort. Proposal. The defensive system of Europa goals of the work perspectives. European network of fortification of the Austro-Hungarian Empire in UNESCO side candidature. Book 2, Fortification of Trentino region. Book 3, Fortification on Veneto, Lombardy, Friuli. Book 4, European fortification. This is an example of how defensive systems have been identified. There is the plan of North Italy, a diagram and aerial photo of the fort of Venice, divided between the mainland and the lagoon. Up to single fort, this is Forte Marghera. Another example of fortification of Peschiera of Verona, with a historical record of the fortification of the city and the report of the current condition with the prospective properties and the conservation status of the fort. The single fort is identified with a text and historical maps and the description of the current state of the conservation, possible restoration and the current use. The graph elaboration of the map make it possible to understand how much the urban development of the city has been considered by the presence of the fort. This makes it clear how much, even today, this important fortified heritage is now an inseparable part of the city. Another important theme is the study of the evolution of fortified system and the typology of the fort. The fort in the various countries have a common reference model. Other types of the fort. At the conclusion of the study, this graph represents the diffusion of the fort in 10 countries and an important fortified heritage for the number of the fort. 560 have been identified and they are spread in the territory of the former empire. The graph summaries the study data, such as the conservation status of the fort. Some are destroyed or in ruins, but many still existed. about 45% of the building, those buildings. The survival force after the destruction of the walls of those caused by urban expansion still remain as an important testimony of the history and the architecture of his city. The remaining fort must now be considered as the cultural heritage of the city, of the nation and the Europe. This study today could promote a going Asia between the country to protect and enhance these fortified heritage. The recovery of the fort with the architectural and the landscape heritage represents an opportunity for the city to improve the quality of urban life, both the suburbs and its historic center. After this catalog, a dossier is produced of the UNESCO candidature of the Fort Trentino. In the absence of a transnational project, has been blocked. Forte Cadine candidacy in the European Heritage Label was successful in 2017. European heritage sites are considered the most significant phase in the construction of today's Europe. The site represents European ideas, values, history, and integration. The site promotes European symbolic values and role playing in the European history and culture. There are also place to promote educational activity, aimed in particular at young people. By European cards, the Fort of Trentino are one of the most important defensive systems built by the Austro-Hungarian Empire between the 19th and 20th century, which unite Danube Plains and the Central and the Eastern Europe with the Po Valley in a single strategic vision. The fortified work present a unified vision of architecture, economy, and the social organization that involved the people of 11 European countries. The more than 18 fortifications in Trentino represent one of the most important defensive systems created by the Austro-Hungarian Empire and a fundamental element in the history, cultural, and landscape of Trentino territory. The graph represents the four phases of the typology evolution of the Fort Trentino. Description of the site. Forte Cadine, 1860, is a part of a ring of fort belt defended Trento. Fort Cadine is the information center on Trentino fortification. It is a place where historical memory is preserved, but also open to the contemporary themes. European significance of the site. The dramatic division caused by the First World War in Land Trentino, which had become a borderline between the Austro-Hungarian Empire and the Kingdom of Italy, to develop a culture of resistance and cooperation between the people. Project. Fort Cadine is a European meeting place for the promotion of common cultural values, open to young people. Part of cultural tourism system, able to connect the different European countries with a similar historical heritage. European history has been distinguished by division and conflict between the peoples. and different defensive systems have been created barriers to separate areas and peoples. The recovery of the Forte Cardine was intended to transform a side of division into a meeting place of the people and territories. Fortification system will become new European cultural networks, offering opportunities for exchange and collaboration and promoting a balanced cultural and social development of the community, integrated into the European Union process. Thank you.
Hi everyone, my name is Davide Allegri and I work for Fondazione Museo Storico del Trentino, which is an Italian foundation for historical research and dissemination. It also holds historical archives about Trentino from 18th century to 20th century. We preserve documents, photos, paintings, objects, but also, more recently, videos and family footages to retain culture and memory. Fort Cardine is one of our spaces, and today I'm here to talk to you about our regional network of forts and what European Heritage Label means for Fort Cardine. Our region is full of fortresses. In nearly 60 years, the Austro-Hungarian Empire built something like 18 forts in various places, developing different types, characteristics and features. Some say that in the historical Tyrol region, the Austrian Empire built two-thirds of its fortifications. It was really a huge effort, not only from the military point of view, but also from the economical, political, social and environmental side. In just half a century, a rural and extremely poor area became a construction site and then a highly restricted military area, with thousands of soldiers coming from all the corners of the empire well before the outbreak of war in 1940. Everyday life was totally changed. New roads were built. The landscape was sometimes completely transformed. The strong military presence brought money but also restrictions. There were conflicts, but there were also encounters between the different people standing in the military sites and the civil population. The cities grew to accommodate soldiers. In the valleys, fortresses, military outposts and facilities brought a clear presence of the state at the edge of the empire. Then, in 1950, the war outbreak, and some of these fortresses were used to stop Italian attacks to Austrian Empire. After the 1918, it started a long period of oblivion in which fortresses were dismantled, sometimes demolished and forgot. In 2009, in the preparation of World War I centennial, the province of Trento decided to plan the restoration of some forts placed throughout the regional territory to preserve memory of an important historical period. Between them, there was also Fort Cardine. In this way, 100 years after their creation, they became again a construction site to return to Trentino people part of its memories. From 2015, the World War I centennial, these sites have been unified inside the Forti Circuit, Circuito Forti, to found a network in which culture and heritage meet. The aim is to go beyond the simple history of the site and technical feature of the military structure, to outline the historical importance of this territory as a place of contested borders and cultural integration in the past. At present, it represents cultural encounters and intercultural dialogue over the historic lessons of Europe. The attempt is to label a fortified space, not just for what happened while it was used, but also for the symbolic message and warning it represents. From this idea, it started Sentinelle di Pietra, Stone Sentries, a rich program of events, performances, lectures, gigs, taking places in summer runs. The network also conceived a diffuse art exhibition called Arte Forte, Strong Art. In 2016 and 2018, Italian artists and galleries were invited to create site-specific pieces of art. In 2018, Fort Cadine gained the European Heritage Label Award. Since then, the site started to promote the label in various forms. For example, guided tours for classes, for tourists, for amateurs, for experts, but also specific TV series and social media campaigns, and placing the label inside and outside the fort. These are some of the recent projects. Art exhibition Parallel Stories, co-produced with Forte Tesoro in Veneto, showcasing two works on apartheid and effects of Soviet regime in Europe. A European-founded project EHLAN, Network of EHL Sites, to develop common strategies for branding, communicate and engage audience in a European narrative. European Heritage Days funded project Fort Europe, nice to meet you. An educational toolkit of 8 videos for high school students and 4 webinars for teachers connecting Fort Cadine history during Austro-Hungarian Empire with current European issues. Il filo della scelta, the thread of choice, a storytelling project of men and women who created Europe. In this way, Fort Cadine has turned itself from a space of military and cultural conflict to a space of cultural encounters.
Trento è in una posizione strategica lungo l'incrocio non solo della Valle dell'Adige ma anche della Val Sugana, solcata dal fiume Brenta, e di quella che viene chiamata la Valle dei Laghi, dove si trova il Forte di Cadine. Fino alla Prima Guerra Mondiale questo territorio era parte dell'Impero Austro-Ungarico. Successivamente alla sconfitta degli Stati Centrali abbiamo una nuova configurazione geografica. Questo territorio diventa territorio italiano. La particolarità di questa costruzione del Forte Cadine è quello di essere parte di un sistema difensivo che comprendeva la città di Trento con una sorta di cintura. Questo forte ha la sua particolarità costruttiva che è data dalla sua configurazione ad arco sulla via di accesso obbligata che conduceva a Trento. Sono certamente molto orgoglioso di questo riconoscimento europeo, un segno quasi che va a riconoscere un'attività che a volte è più nascosta, sommersa, ma che ha come stella polare quello appunto della conservazione della memoria, una memoria che è essenziale per non ricadere negli errori, per migliorare, ma anche per capire che chi era su fronti opposti, può dialogare, può incontrarsi e può vedere una linea di frontiera spostarsi, scomparire, sempre in una prospettiva di unità europea.
Forte Cadine è innanzitutto un centro informativo che permette al visitatore che per la prima volta viene a visitare questo territorio fortificato, questo territorio segnato appunto dai conflitti e dalla guerra, e permette di dare delle chiavi di lettura, delle interpretazioni, delle informazioni. Questi sono musei effettivamente, ma sono musei che hanno l'obiettivo di trasmetterci anche l'emozione pensando a quei poveri, scusate, soldati e ufficiali che si trovavano qui durante la guerra, che parlavano lingue tra loro diverse e che sono, come dire, all'origine della nostra Europa.
Forte Cadine è un luogo della memoria, ma nello stesso tempo vuole essere il luogo della contemporaneità. Un racconto che continua e che è rafforzato attraverso la conoscenza di quanto è stata difficile, tormentata, drammatica questa costruzione europea e come da questo si è ripartiti a farla diventare un luogo di incontro di popoli e di territori i quali possono collaborare insieme in una situazione di pace.